Hey guys, so welcome back to another budget video. We are officially in June. We're already like in mid-June going into July. So yeah, so today I just kind of wanted to do kind of like my previous video where I just kind of wrote down like a kind of like pay bills with me and a little chit-chat video also. So today's a special month. For me, because today, this month, my son is turning 7, so we have something fun planned for him. We're just gonna go to like a arcade place and have fun. So I'm excited. He's excited. He's gonna have a bunch of his cousins, some of his friends. So for June, I'm just gonna go ahead and write down the bills that I already did pay. We did have a payday already on the 8th and the 14th, and we did have some carry over, like leftover money from May, which was May was like a extra paycheck month, as you can say. But my husband did spend a lot of money. You guys know already. My husband likes to spend money, and yeah, so we spent money, and I also did spend money too, but of course, majority is him. So we kind of spent that extra check. So let me go ahead and write down the bills that so far that I have paid for, and then also I'm gonna write down after that the bills that we still have to pay for. So let's go ahead and write that down. So I already paid for rent. So let me go ahead and kind of zoom in so you guys can see. So I already went ahead. I paid for rent, which rent I was normally paying 300, but it got bumped up another 100, and then the $6 is because we have the purified water. So went ahead and my parents went ahead and added that in. So now it's 406, and hey, I ain't complaining because living here in Hawaii, a studio is like 1200, could be up to 1500. So I mean, right now I'm blessed to be able to, only have a room, but I do have help with my son, and it's always good to be around family, so rent is good. All right, and then I also did pay internet. Oh, sorry guys, this is my tripod. So my internet. Which was 5207. All right, so this is separate from my rent because we did purchase internet for us because of the connection was too far. We do have like a pretty large like white house, so the Wi-Fi wasn't as sh didn't get to our room here in the back, so we went ahead and bought that. We could have bought extender, which I'm gonna look into, so that that we can go ahead and eliminate that. But I think mostly it was for the gaming because my son and my husband, mostly my son plays online on the PS4. So if you guys know about if you guys have husbands or kids who game, the connection has to be good. All right, and then I went ahead and I also paid for my cell phone. So my cell phone, I'm gonna write here. So it was $96.39, but I minus $64 because we did some irrigation at my parents' house. So my husband installed it and we purchased the parts. So I just told my dad that I'm gonna minus it from my cell phone because I pay my portion to him. Oh, that's my son coming through. Can you close the door? Thank you. So it came out to $32.29. So that's what I paid for. All right, so the next thing that I paid for was my car insurance. So I paid for my car insurance. which was 29.83. And then I kind of want to go into these. The what I'm about to write wasn't like part of June. It was technically like late. Sometimes I pay some things a little late from last month, which is not a good habit, I know. But the truck registration was due last month, but they didn't send the little piece of paper to go with it. It just didn't come in the mail, so I had to physically go with my mother-in-law to go pay for it, because the loan is under them. So of course the truck was registered under them, and they're super strict about people. I guess, you know, that person who's registered had to come and pay it and bring the registration. So I was like, okay, that's, I thought it was kind of irritating, because it's like, okay, I'm just trying to pay the registration, you know, like, let me pay it. It's not like, who the hell would want to go and pay someone's, like, we paid $550 because it is a diesel truck, so it's heavy, and of course in Hawaii it's a bit more expensive, but yeah, like, just let me pay it, y'all. So I'm going to write in red here. So truck registration, so I pay that. That was $5.58. So I paid that, and then I also paid my husband's cell phone. And I could have, see, that the thing, I don't know if I mentioned it, the thing with my husband's cell phone is that, you know, I pay with my mother-in-law, and it's usually 60, you know, but then she's been paying it late, so then, yeah, this $30 fee, and she only paid a portion of 100, so I was like, you know what, I'm just going to pay for it, and the next one, I'm not going to pay for it. So 60 plus, it came out to like 91.69, so just say 31.69. So that's what I paid over the amount that wasn't what I was supposed to. I paid for it because I didn't want it to shut off and stuff. What else did I pay? I think that was it. Yeah, that was it for now. So I'm gonna write down, let me go ahead and do like a check of the ones that I did pay for. And then I'm gonna go ahead and write in the bills that I still have to pay for. So yeah, like I said, with our extra paycheck, we did spend a little. My husband did, you know, he purchased like tires for his other truck. We kind of treated ourselves at Ross. I mean, it's a good deal, but we don't normally, like, I think we spent like $200 that day. But I did purchase like a backpack and a new wallet and some, couple of clothes and stuff for the house. So I mean, all fair games, it was good. And then I always think of it as I didn't really even spend my income tax money, so it's like treating myself, you know. And of course this registration was a pain in my behind. Like, that's a big chunk. Like, I could be paying a lot with that. Yeah, we just kind of fallen off the wagon a little, so we have to get back on track. We still have, I'm getting paid this upcoming Friday on the 22nd, and then my husband's gonna get paid on the 28th. So let me write down the bills that we still have to pay for. So I do still have leftover money, so I'm holding on to that so that I can pay for these other bills. So the other one that I have still have to pay for is the painstakingly the truck. We have two trucks now, but the one that's the highest, of course, just $1,069.90. And then we have to pay for the other truck, which I just put as Toyota's, so I know that's $202.91. Ooh, what's that? And then we also have the insurance. The insurance for the two trucks, so they were on separate accounts two different car insurance, but then I told my mother-in-law to put the Toyota onto the one with the other truck, so combined it, and it was a good price. So I'm just gonna put truck insurances, and that is, it's 120 for two of the trucks combined. So that's good. I save about $50. So any money you can save. And then I also still have my student loan. And also my personal loan, which this one fluctuates, but I'm just gonna pay 160 to this. It's always 160. Last month I paid like 200 because it came out to like 180 something, but this statement came out to like 151 or 55, so I'm just gonna put 160. And then we have the bed. And then we have my husband's cell phone again, which I'm only gonna pay $60. No more. Alright, we also have the Synchrony Bank, which this one's almost done. I know. I made that video about paying off, and I'm always like, I still have that money I could pay off. Like I said, I still have money for my income tax, but I'm just kind of letting it be. I'm like, I could, you know, but then maybe that might, like, I mean, I don't have to tell my husband, but maybe, like, if I tell him that we paid it off, then he's gonna think, oh, that's some extra money. But no, we didn't, because he added another truck on there, you know, and all these other bills. So yeah, so these are the bills that I still have to pay for. Let me just zoom out. Yeah, so these are those bills I still have to pay for. Like I said, we have still have two more paychecks. These two bills land on the 30th, of course, if I have enough money. The 28th paycheck should pay for this, and then going on to July. Yeah, so yeah. And I'm really stoked because, I mean, my old job, I wasn't making full 80 hours. Like, they cut our hours in like June, not June, January. So I wasn't bringing home as much as I would like to. I mean, I was bringing home good money still, but I'm making like full-time hours. So definitely that helps out a lot. Yeah, so I'm just trying to figure out what my plans are for this month and next month, more for next month, I guess, so I can figure out like more of like our strategy and how we're gonna save more money. I do have to save for a big trip coming up next year for my niece's graduation in the mainland. So that's gonna be a lot, because from here to California, would have to pay like three people. That comes up around almost 3,000. That's not even including like the food. We're gonna road trip, also see some other family, do a lot of activities. You know, we don't travel a lot, we don't do vacations, so if we do it, we're gonna do it big. And we're also, you know, visiting family, so it's always exciting. Yeah, so this is what I have. I don't have a running total on it. It's just kind of doing a random, not random, but spontaneous video. I'm using my new desk that I purchased from Ross, which I bought, so it like folds out, and then I can also fold it back in. So it's like one of those, you know, those little tables that you guys eat, like if you're eating on the couch or whatever, but it's like a bigger version. But it's cute, like super cute. And yeah, then I can, if I don't need it, you need to use it, you can just fold it back out and then just put it to the side. So it's pretty cool. So yeah, so I'll just leave the video here. I don't want to make it too long, and I will see you guys in my next video. Thanks, guys.